Why does my phone's internet feel faster than my computer's? Seriously, I swear I upgraded from dial-up. Hey guys, what's going on? I'm Trisha Hirschberger, and in this episode of DIY in 5, we're going to show you how to increase your speed. Internet speed, that is. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to see more tips for speeding up your system. First, you gotta check that hardware. We're not trying to sound like your ISP's tech support, but seriously, did you reset the modem? It sounds so cliche, but that can actually help. Just think about it. Your modem is on 24/7, pinging the internet, getting emails, streaming Netflix, updating Twitter. There's bound to be a few bits that just got lost. Resetting your modem is kind of like street sweeping. It clears out those little bits that can slow you down. This goes for your PC too. If you keep it on all the time, give it a power down once in a while. Okay, now to deal with plugins. Remember the days of browser extensions that would just install anytime you loaded a new program? Yeah, those are still a thing. Go into your browser's plugin options and check out what you've got loaded. It might surprise you. Speaking of programs, your system might be set to open unnecessary apps at startup. Depending on what they are, it might slow down your internet connection. It's always good to check out your startup apps and see what might be dragging you down. We'll add links to our videos which show you how to check those out below. It's important to note that not all browsers are created equal either. Some have really robust features with lots of functionality, some are highly customizable, and some just get you online. If you're using a browser with lots of features, like Chrome, it might be eating up resources. Try switching to Safari, Microsoft Edge, or even Opera. They won't give you all the extra add-ons, but they can potentially load pages faster. Okay, so Trisha, you say, what if you've reset your hardware, checked plugins, and switched over to a faster browser and you're still running slow? It might be time to upgrade your service. Many of us bundle our internet with our TV and don't think too much about how fast the actual service is. To get the cheapest plans, you usually also get the slowest speeds. It might be worth an extra 10 bucks a month for the extra speed. With everyone in the house connected at once, trying to stream Netflix, watch the latest DIY in 5, and who knows what else, that 25 megabit internet connection just won't cut it. Remember to compare download versus upload speeds if you do any live streaming, and to look at the benefits of a dedicated versus a best effort line. So what's the fastest internet available in your area? Anybody on Google Fiber? Ugh, I am so jealous if you are. Check out these other great tips to speed up your system, and I will see you next time with more DIY in 5.